Good morning and welcome to our Mass. Today's Gospel talks about being friends or enemies of Jesus. The friends of Jesus listen to the Word of God and act upon it, even when it's unpopular to do so.
The Gospel asks us to think about this. Are we friends of Jesus or are we enemies? Do we listen to His words and try to follow them? Let us pray that we will be able to repent our sins and always remain friends of the Lord.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Sisters and brothers, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these beautiful mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Enlighten, O God of compassion, the hearts of your children, sanctified by penance, and in your loving kindness, grant those you stirred in a sense of devotion a gracious hearing when they cry out to you. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Daniel. King Nebuchadnezzar said,
Meshach, and Abednego. I hear that you refuse to worship my gods and the gold statue I have set up. Now I'm going to give you one more chance. If you bow down and worship the statue when you hear the music, everything will be all right. But if you don't, you will once be thrown into a flaming furnace. No god can save you from me. The three men replied, Your Majesty, we do not need to defend ourselves. The god we worship can save us from you and your flaming furnace. But even if he doesn't, we still won't worship your gods.
Nebuchadnezzar's face twisted with anger at the three men. He ordered the furnace to be heated 7 times hotter than usual. Next, he commanded some of his strongest soldiers to tie up the men and throw them into the flaming furnace. Suddenly, the king jumped up and shouted, Weren't only 3 men tied up and thrown into the fire? Yes, Your Majesty, the people answered, but I see 4 men walking around in the fire, the king replied. None of them is tied up or harmed, and the fourth one looks like an angel. Then the king cried out, Praise the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego for sending an angel to rescue his servants. They trusted their God and refused to obey my commands. They choose to die than rather worship or serve any god except their own. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with
your spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to those Jews who believed in him, "If you keep on obeying what I have said, you truly are my disciples. You will know the truth, and the truth will set you free." They answered, "We are Abraham's children. We have never been anyone's slaves. How can you say we will be set free?" Jesus replied, "I tell you for certain that anyone who sins is a slave of sin, and slaves do not stay in the family forever. Though the Son will always remain in the family, if the Son gives you freedom, you are free. I know that you are from Abraham's family, yet you want to kill me because my message is not really in your hearts. I am telling you what my Father has shown me, just as you are doing what your Father has taught you." The people said back to Jesus, "Abraham is our father." Jesus replied, "If you were Abraham's children, you would do what Abraham did. Instead, you want to kill me for telling you the truth that God gave me. Abraham never did anything like that. But you are doing exactly what your father does." The Jews then said, "Do not accuse us of having someone else as our father. We just have one father, and he is God." Jesus answered, "If God were your father, you would love me, because I came from God and only from him. I did not come on my own. He sent me." The Gospel of the Lord. Have you noticed the readings during the Lent season, during the weekdays and the weekends? They're pretty intense. There's all kinds of things going on. Temptations, thirst, blindness. Today we're hearing about furnaces and fire. Whew, that's pretty intense stuff. Now I have to say, I love this first reading. We'll look at this. Sometimes I don't always understand what God is saying in the scriptures. And sometimes I need help. So I go to different resources, those experts who can help break these things down and help me understand. So like today, one of the things that we're learning is that God sees in a whole different way than I do. I see just like surface things, external things. God sees those too, but then he always goes deeper. He's always going deeper to look in our hearts. He knows us, body, mind, heart, soul, spirit, every fiber of our being, every strand of our DNA, our happy body cells and unhappy body cells. He knows even deeper than that. So that's what the readings are kind of teaching us. I love that first reading, those Old Testament names. They're just fun names. You don't hear them a lot. Nebuchadnezzar, King Nebuchadnezzar. What else? Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego. They're not very common names. You don't hear today like, I'd like to introduce my son, Nebuchadnezzar. Isn't very common. We call him Neb, for short. Or my uncle Shadrach will be in town. Or Grandpa Abednego. Those are just classic Old Testament names. They really grab you when you hear those names. You want to know the story. Who are these people? Well, the readings today are unpacking this, we see the surface, but there's so much more going on underneath, isn't there? So we hear the story from Daniel in the first reading, and then this beautiful gospel. Jesus is trying to help the Jews and the Pharisees and the scribes. He's trying to help them go deeper. You know, yes, they're good with the law, they see the externals, they're following everything, but go deeper. Look into the heart, and he's trying to unpack this for them. He even says, the truth will set you free. They don't understand, because he's pushing them beyond their kind of like comfort zone in their faith journeys. He's trying to say that sin does not lead to freedom. And they're in sin. He's trying to point that out to them. Truth. See, he's unpacking this, going deeper. Truth, which is Jesus. It's not some abstract concept. It's a real person. You hear someone saying, gosh, what is truth? I'm seeking truth. What they're saying is they're looking for Jesus. And that kind of truth always leads to freedom from sin. And that's beautiful. Always unpacking these things. This is one of the resources I read. Maybe to help us a little better is the example of a block of marble or granite. One great genius artist. His works are still admired today in Rome, all over the world. What he would do before a project that he would start, a statue, it would take him a while. He would inspect different blocks of marble and granite. And he would just look at the surface, see all the flaws, everything he would have to do to work around the pits in there, the different lines. And he would take his time and look at these. And maybe you've heard this before. And then he would look at that and look and look. And he would see the flaws. And yet he could see the statue hidden inside that block of marble. He could see it. The final project. That's amazing. That's kind of what God is doing. He looks at us. Father Tim, I'm a block of marble. Lots of flaws, sins, all kinds of things, pits. And then just little by little, God takes a step back and he starts to remove these things because he sees in you and I the image of Christ. Whew. Thank God he's willing to do that. And if we're willing to take our time, be patient, have a little bit taken out of the block of marble that we are, the beautiful image of Christ that has been given to us in our baptism. Jesus, or God, will finish the final product and will look absolutely beautiful in heaven as the final project, the final statue. So it's beautiful to reflect that because Christ is deep inside. So the readings really are teaching us. We find that, again, in the first reading. Nebuchadnezzar, King Nebuchadnezzar. I love saying that name, Nebuchadnezzar. I can't spell it, but I can say it. Remember what he did? Threw Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego deep into the furnace. And they should have been disintegrated instantly. But then he looks in there. He looks deeper, like deeper into the marble, deeper into the furnace. What does he find? Not three, four. An angel was there. Same thing with us. Even in the fires of temptation or whatever we come across in our lives, God will always help us. He'll send an angel to help guide us. Even in the most difficult times, sometimes they're called fires of temptation. So these are good things to reflect on. Now when you go home, you can dazzle your family with the names, Old Testament names. Nebuchadnezzar, Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego. And you can tell the story of the fiery furnace. So we pray to God this morning. Please, Lord, help us to be your true disciples today and every day of our lives. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. And together we stand, and we'll offer up a few prayers and petitions to our Heavenly Father this morning.
For the leaders of our church, especially Archbishop Lucas, Father Mike, Father Taylor, and Father Tim, that they may help us to continue to follow Jesus and his teachings. We pray to the Lord.
For the leaders of the world, that they work together to promote peace and justice. We pray to the Lord.
For our school community, may we continue to grow closer to God during this Lenten season. We pray to the Lord.
For all essential workers, that God will protect their health as they continually put themselves at risk in service to others. We pray to the Lord.
For all who are sick and suffering, and those who do not have anyone to pray for them, may they feel God's loving presence. We pray to the Lord.
For all those who have died and are joined with God in heaven, especially Billy Cronin, who we are remembering at this Mass, and for all the needs we hold in the silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Heavenly Father, hear all our prayers. Give us the grace this morning. Fill our hearts with a special grace to see in each other the image of Christ and the image of Christ in ourselves. We ask all these things through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Our toy song can be found in our book at number 398, drawn to you, number 398.
Thank you.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive back, O Lord, these sacrificial offerings which you have given to be offered to the honor of your holy name, and grant that they may become remedies for our healing. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For through the saving passion of your Son, Jesus Christ, the whole world has received a heart to confess the infinite power of your loving majesty, since by the wondrous power of the cross, your judgment on the world is now revealed in the authority of Christ crucified. And so, Lord, with all the angels and saints, we too give you thanks, as in exaltation we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and George our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Well, thank you very much. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, thank you.
prayed, number 438.
Thank you.
Let us pray. May the mysteries we have just received this morning, O Lord, bring us heavenly medicine, that they may purge all evil from our heart and strengthen us with eternal protection. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And
with your spirit. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Thanks be to God. Please kneel for our adoration.
Exposition can be found in your books at number 670. I'll see you in the book.
Because we see with the eyes of faith. What do I do? Now, I think you're all scheduled for adoration throughout the day. Oh, yes, I'm getting something good. Sometimes I don't even know what to do. Sometimes we'll have different formal prayers. We'll read maybe a rosary or something. One of the best things, they're all good, is just let your heart be open. As we during the day, as we do our adoration, let your heart be open and just let Jesus love us. Just open up your heart. You don't even have to say anything. Jesus will love us. And then what do we do in return? Jesus, I love you so much. So that's just something to think about. Look deeper. Jesus is here.